officially, well, we're not officially heading off to go camping, but we're almost heading off to go camping. I'm going to a new place. It's not like in the Sierras. It's up by Marysville, if that means anything to anyone. So it's going to be a little different because I'm used to camping up in Tahoe. So we'll see how it goes. Actually, you just go through Marysville and then, I don't know. It's just a little different. We'll see. I just got to my campsite and I got it all set up. We're going to walk down to the lake now. Through there, that's not sunlight. That's crystal blue emerald water. I'm trying to hike down there right now, and it's taking forever. So beautiful. The bluest water I've ever seen. So apparently this is clay. I could tell that it was clay when I was stepping on it. But I put my foot in over here, and I sunk all the way to the bottom, all the way up to my knee right there. And I got really scared. I thought it was quicksand and I was gonna die. But then I was okay. The hike down here, I'm like, oh, this is so nice and serene and so beautiful. I stripped. And I knew that I was going downhill the whole time. I was like, shit, this is gonna suck going back uphill. And guess what? It does. So steep. I didn't realize, like, coming down how steep it was, but I'm realizing it now. And it hurts. It hurts a lot. I ate a donut today, and I am paying for it right now. I made it back, and now I am swinging in my hammock. My most favorite thing about camping is my hammock.
In my pajamas.
Christy's favorite. She always makes fun of me because I wear these same long johns every time I go camping. But I just made a fire. Get my boobs out of there, geez please. I just built that by myself. Ah! I'm in front of the fire that I've made. Look at it. It's just still going amazingly. All right, so I have the fire going, and I'm trying to boil some water, and I have a feeling it's going to take a long time. But I am making camping omelets. And what you do is you put the eggs in the bag, and then you put all your goodies in there, and then you're going to shake it up. So I'm going to shake up my omelets. So I learned this from Margot's mom, Janice Hess, and I'm really excited to do it on my own this time. So what you do is you get all this in the bag, and you shake it up. And then you put it in the boiling water and you let it boil until it cooks. Hopefully I can get my water to boil. It's been really hard getting the fire started this morning. My fire just started to die, so it was really hard to get the water to boil. I don't think the water actually ever boiled. It looked like it was gonna, and it never did. And so my omelet came out a little soggy, but it did cook a little bit. So that's okay. So now we're going to eat my omelet and a donut. All right, I'm going to try my omelet. Not bad. Not the best, but not the worst. All right, I'm going to enjoy my omelet and fix these bangs. What's going on?
Hooroo! So I am headed to Mushroom Hole.
So, apparently the last place I was just at was private property. My bad. And so I kind of got in trouble for being there. The guy came over and talked to me and was like, oh, it's my property, you know, you could stay here if you want. But I felt obligated to leave. And I knew this place that I'm at now was up the river, so I was like, I'll just go there. And look how beautiful it is. Right here is a big, like, jump where you could jump in. It doesn't even look that big in this video right now. And I've done it before. I've jumped off before, but for some reason I'm really scared to do it this time. So I don't know if I'm going to do it, but I want to do it. It's fun. I'm just scared. I'm a big baby. Wah, wah, wah. I'm just going to go play in the little shallow water above the waterfalls.
Oh my God. Minutes, seconds after my last video, I dropped my phone in the bottom of one of those waterfalls. And I've never had more of an anxiety attack. Like, I was freaking out. And you know, I just got the new waterproof case before this trip, right? So I'm thinking, it's fine, as long as I can find it. And so I find it, and it's like, there's slopes. The rocks are just slopes there, and it's like granite, slippery slopes. Like, you can't walk on them. I'd like slide down them. Hence why my phone slid down one into the water. And so I'm like climbing all around, and I find it, and I see it. And I'm like, okay, I just have to jump in. But it's kind of deep. It's like 5 feet down in this under, and like right by the waterfall where the water's like swirling. And like, so I'm freaking out because I already told you guys, I was too scared to jump there, right? So I'm freaking out. I get in the water. I try to get it, and I can't. So there had been some guys there when I first got there, and I was like, oh, maybe they're still at the top, like where their cars are, like I'm gonna go find them. And so I went up there, they were gone. And the guy that I was trespassing on his property before, like he had talked to me and he was really nice, and he was like, you know, you can stay here, but just want you to know this is my property, blah, blah, blah. And so he was super nice and everything. So, and he introduced himself to me, his name was Scott. And I thought, well, if Scott's still there, like maybe he'll do it, you know? So I drive back over to his property and he's still there, and he agrees to go back and dive down for me to get my phone. And so we like hike, you know, drive back to where I was, hike down, get all over there. I show him where it's at. He's like, okay, yeah, I think I can get it. I can get it. Nicest man in the world. He dove down, got my phone, and thank goodness for my waterproof case. My phone is 100% intact, perfectly fine. This phone sat at the bottom of the river, under a waterfall, for like an hour, and is perfectly fine. So him and I hiked back up, and I hit my nose on a rock, and I hit it really hard, like on a big boulder. And I kind of feel like I have a concussion now, and like, oh, I'm like, but at least I have my phone. I don't care if I die in my sleep tonight, I have my phone. I sat there maybe 20, 30 minutes just looking at my phone under the water, thinking, like trying to pep talk myself. I'm like, you're a strong woman. You go camping by yourself. You came out here by yourself. Like, you can do this. Like, hell no.
Since my big water scare, I came back to my tent and I took a nap. Oh, my face looks so bad. I'm sorry, you guys. I'm sorry you have to see me so ugly. It totally hit, like, all of this right here is what hit that chunk. I was like, bam, on the rug. Bam. My fire is now really, really taking off. I'm so excited. I made a chili potato and a pesto potato. Probably won't be able to eat both, but so far, they are really good. So I'm just gonna enjoy my fire and my dinner. Whoop, whoop. Yay for camping.